गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे अगेन इन क्लास सिक्स ज्योग्राफी आई विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम टेरेस फार्मिंग। बट वन स्टूडेंट हैड आस्क्ड मी दैट व्हाट इज शिफ्टिंग फार्मिंग। आई हैड एक्सप्लेन इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो, यू कैन रिफर टू दैट वीडियो, ऑलरेडी आई हैव एक्सप्लेन। एंड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ, यू हैड आस्क्ड अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ शिफ्टिंग फार्मिंग। सो सिंपली यू राइट, शिफ्टिंग फार्मिंग इन्वॉल्व्स क्लियरिंग अ स्मॉल एरिया of a forest by cutting down all the trees and burning the area. The farmer uses the land for growing crops for several years. Once the soil fertility diminishes, the area is abandoned. Another patch of land is selected and the process is repeated. Up to here, what is shifting farming? Okay, up to here. Okay, from the beginning, what is shifting farming? You can write this definition. And in which region shifting farming is practiced in India? Example, Northeast India. Okay, Northeast India is the place in India where shifting farming is practiced. Other than India, other places like Southeast Asia and the Amazon basin of South America. Okay, in these two places also shifting farming is practiced. Now we go to terrace farming. Okay. So terrace cultivation on hill slopes and valleys is a settled cultivation system. Okay, so terrace cultivation is done in hilly slopes and valley region. Okay, you can see terrace farming over here. These are the slopes of the hill, and on these slopes you can see that these are step like structure. Okay, steps like structure which are built, made in order to do terrace farming. This type of farming helps to conserve soil moisture and also to prevent land degradation and soil erosion. Okay, so why terrace farming is done over here? Because it conserves soil moisture, it retains the soil moisture, that is the water, and prevent land degradation from becoming barren and soil erosion also. Okay, to prevent soil erosion. Soil erosion means the top soil because of flowing water is washed away. When there is heavy down rain, the water will pass water will run through this valley in a very fast way. Okay, the speed of the flowing water will be very fast, and so that can erode the soil, that can remove the top soil, and the top soil will get eroded. Okay, it will be drained. So these steps are cut because these steps will act as breakers, speed breakers. They will break the flow of the water. The speed of the flowing water will get reduced because of these steps, and so the erosion, the rate of erosion will decrease. That is why terrace farming is done in hilly areas and in valley regions. Did you understand? And also to prevent land degradation, because the top soil is the most fertile soil, and if the top soil gets eroded, then that land will turn into barren land, it will lose its fertility. So to prevent land degradation and soil erosion. In this system, bench trestles are constructed on hill slopes running across the slopes. So you can see like bench. Okay, these are bench like structure which are cut in the on the slopes. Okay, for terrace cultivation. Terrace cultivation is practiced in hilly regions of Northeast India. So this this type of cultivation is done in Northeast India and in hilly regions. Then in countries like China, Japan, Philippines, and around the Mediterranean Sea, in that area also terrace cultivation is done. Terrace cultivation, you can see if you go to some hill station like Darjeeling or Shimla or Shillong, on the slopes you will find the people, local people growing tea. Okay, tea and terrace cultivation like this, slopes like this, steps like benches you will see over there. Okay, so this is about terrace farming. Then so these were based on relief features. Okay, now we go to the purpose. Based on purpose of farming. What is the purpose? Why people do farming? So in this four types are there. subsistence farming, intensive farming, commercial farming or extensive farming and plantation farming. So first we will see what is subsistence farming. Subsistence farming means to produce as much only to satisfy family or local needs. So first thing is that the production is that much as we need, okay, to satisfy the needs of our family and also for local needs, that is the people who live there, okay, to satisfy the food requirement of the local local people as well as the family, and little left over for transport elsewhere, and something small left over so that they can sell it in the market and earn some money for transport take it to the market, okay, and sell it over there for other requirement, because only food is not sufficient. We need clothes, we need a shelter and other things also. For that we need money, so a little left over that is transported elsewhere to be sold over there and earn little money. So this is called subsistence farming. This type of farming is practiced in the monsoon regions of Southeast Asia. Okay, monsoon regions, monsoon is the name of a wind, and this wind brings plenty of rain, okay, in India and in Southeast Asia region. And so this type of subsistence farming is practiced in Southeast Asia, in India also and in Southeast Asia. Okay, so this is subsistence farming. Then another is intensive farming. Intensive farming is done for commercial purpose. Okay, commercial, see over here, commercial purpose means to do business. The main purpose is to make money, earn profit. Okay, so commercial purpose, to do trade, to do business, that is for selling the farm's produce. The purpose is not over here. What did we see? That they are producing only to satisfy their family needs and local needs. But over here, commercial purpose, for selling the farm produce in the market. The farmer cultivates to make profit. The main aim of the farmer is to make profit, to earn money. With a high use of inputs like high quality seeds, fertilizers. So in order to make profit, you need to grow more, okay, a maximum. And for that, we use high quality seeds or fertilizers. In Green Revolution, you have studied. I had given you the project on Green Revolution. So in that, you have studied that how a high yielding variety seeds or fertilizers or pesticides and insecticides, okay, all are used in order to have a good production, okay, good agricultural production. This type of farming is mainly practiced in highly developed countries, okay, in developed countries like USA, okay, or other European countries, okay, developed country, they export the agricultural produce to other countries, and in this they earn lot of money. Okay, so today today's video I will be teaching up to here. Then in my next video I will be taking up commercial farming and plantation farming. So I hope you have understood, and read the chapter, write what is subsistence farming, what is intensive farming, what is shifting agriculture or shifting farming or terrace farming. Okay, write the definition of all this in your geography copy. Till then, take care. Don't go out of your home, stay inside and be safe. Okay, thank you.